Blog Talk Radio.
And it's the music of my man, Lionel Jones, right here on Blog Talk Radio. You can find him at Facebook.com, or you can just hit him up at CDBaby.com. Well, good evening, good afternoon, good morning to you and yours, wherever you are on the World Wide Web. You are listening to Let's Talk, brought to you by the Men Empowered Radio Show on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com. My name is Brother Malachi. I am your host and founder of the Men Empowered Organization. It is August 11th, 2013. If you'd like to join in on our show conversation while we are here live, and yes, we are here live right here on Blog Talk Radio. I didn't think I was going to get on in time enough to go ahead and open up, but it finally came. Having some technical difficulties with the network, but we are here live. And tonight it is a Sunday, and that means it's the Book of Jasher. The Book of Jasher, chapter 36. The chat room is open, and if you'd like to make any comments or if you have any questions before we get into the lesson, you can hit us up at 347-205-9279 and press 1 on your phone. I'd like to remind you that the Men Empowered Organization's phone lines are, when we are off air, is 601-297-2927 or at 504-484-9388. Well, and our email address is menempoweredtoprosper@yahoo.com. While I think I have control right now, I'm going to go ahead and take a quick music break, and we'll get back into some announcements as well as the editorial. If you didn't catch our editorial on Monday for the special edition that we had of Jasher chapter 24. So we're going to go ahead and do that editorial for last week, and we'll be right back right after these.
Cleaning out my closet, mixtape.
Yeah, to everyone listening, what's going on? Eshawn Burke, let's go. Yeah, a 1-2 y'all, ain't get on stop. Say 1-2 y'all, ain't get on stop. A 1-2 y'all, ain't get on stop. Riding for peace, you know we are the sure shot. A 1-2 y'all, ain't get on stop. Say 1-2 y'all, ain't get on stop. A 1-2 y'all, ain't get on stop. Riding for peace, you know we are the sure shot. Hey yo, my reason and my purpose for writing down these words is my brothers on the curb, running after they urges. Some have become herbalists, crack killers and murderers, cat pillars, act like gorillas in a terminus. Already took the earth from us, plainclothes burglars, ran up on the homeland with hammers, fan merciless, on the sand, circled us. A full blitz from the boat, they hurried to approach the surplus, threw us on the block for a dollar, why to purchase us? Now I hear the cannon burst and bust over my shoulder, man, it's us trying to murder us. Banging over, dropping by in a black truck, I don't know what's up, man. For real, hey yo, I don't know what's up. Can't believe they trying to kill it on. Somebody gotta put the king back on the throne. So I'm here to do it. You gotta believe this is more than music. Listen to the wind and I can hear what they speak about. Besides screaming out, I got that reefer out. Talking about the next speaker out, man, they reaching out. They ask each other what the boys eat about. Say, I know we raised in the hood, but can we get out? The answer is yes, this is over the hand in the tech. Can produce tears, blood, and sweat. Just like the compression of your chest. Can produce breath, and that breath produce stress. You can produce success. Yes, I bet all of my loot are proven too blessed. Spend all of my times out for these lines in the U.S. I like the rhymes that show up on the news desk. Get a message to who's best. God, make them new and fresh. Yeah, please. fresh, I made it a point to never forget about the rest.
Of the Men Empowered Commentary right here on the Pine Belt's original Urban FM. It is Thursday, August the 8th, 2013. My name is Brother Malachi of the Men Empowered Organization. As always, we wish to thank Mr. Vernon C. Floyd and his staff for inviting us here to share with you absolute knowledge and truth. We can be reached at 601-297-2927 and online at menempoweredtoprosper@yahoo.com. And our web address is www.blogtalkradio.com/menempowered. Last week, at the end of our commentary, I mentioned the fact that Christ is a black man. Revelation chapter 1, verses 14 and 15 describing Christ. This past Saturday evening, I had a conversation with a friend of mine who recently visited West Africa. The person who was checking her passport noticed on her passport her ethnicity mentioned African American. He mentioned to her she had European features and should be listed as a European American. Let me mention, if you see her, you will know that she is black. How far off was he trying to put an answer on ethnicity? Yes, we have a melting pot of black and brown in all shades since slavery, but the fact remains, you are still black. Did you know the continent of Africa was named after Roman general Scipio Africanus? In this brief explanation, land and countries were named after the inhabitants of the land after the flood. The names of the northern part of Africa was named after Ham's son Canaan and not Africa. The language and names of our people came from Eber, the son of Sela, whose great-great-great-grandfather is Shem. Hebrew derived from Eber, Genesis chapter 11. Finally, Israel came from the father of the 12 tribes of Israel, Jacob. As the people grew, we were known as Hebrew Israelites. The northern kingdom, primarily of the 10 tribes of the 12 tribes of Israel, came to the Americas and is mentioned in the deleted books of the Bible taken out by the Roman Catholic Church. The past weeks, we have had mentioned the fact that the other two tribes were in the southern part of Israel, Judah and Levi, and fled into Africa in 70 A.D. The reason why the deletion of the 14 books is to cover up one of the biblical facts in 2 Esdras chapter 13 verses 40 through 45, and it reads, verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Osi the king, whom Salmanus the king of Assyria led away captive and carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land. Verse 41. But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitudes of the heathen and go forth into further country, where never mankind dwelt. Verse 42. That they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land. Verse 43. And they entered into the Euphrates by the narrow passage of the rivers. Verse 44. For the Most High then showed signs for them, and held still the flood, till they were passed over. Verse 45. For through that country there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half. And the same region is called Arsarit. Arsarit is known today as the Americas. This information from the 1611 King James Bible, known as the Apocrypha books, clearly shows that Christopher Columbus read the Bible to find out where the 10 tribes traveled to. Malcolm X said it right. How can you discover something when it had already been discovered? This land was called by our forefathers Arsarit, meaning hidden land. Let us not forget that all 12 tribes were under Egyptian slavery until Moses was set up by the Most High God to deliver them out of Egypt. Egypt, from the line of Ham, enslaved the Hebrews from Shem. This is not DNA. This is Bible, of where the Most High people would be scattered in the earth. With that in mind, the stage was set up to bring the rest of the tribes into the so-called Americas in Deuteronomy chapter 28, verses 15 through 68. Verse 15, but it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Most High God, to observe to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command thee this day, that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee. Deuteronomy 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thy eyes shall look and fall with longing for them all the day long, and there shall be no might in thy hand. Verse 36, the Most High shall bring thee and thy king, which thou shalt set over thee, unto a nation which neither thou nor thy fathers have ever known, and there shalt thou serve other gods, wood and stone. Verse 37, and thou shalt become an astonishment, a proverb, and a byword among all nations, whether the Most High shall lead thee. Verse 41, thou shalt begat sons and daughters, but thou shalt not enjoy them, for they shall go into captivity. Verse 48, therefore shalt thou serve thy enemies, which the Most High shall send against thee in hunger, and in thirst, and in nakedness, and in want of all things, and he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck until he have destroyed thee. And finally, Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68, and the Most High shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way whereof I spoke unto thee. thou shalt see it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondsmen and bondswomen, and no man shall buy you. If you know history, this is people of color in the Western Hemisphere. Like I said before, the Most High is waking up his people. Time is winding down for the return of Christ, and Israel is rising. The views and opinions of this commentary is strictly of the Men Empowered organization and not the opinions of this radio station. My name is Brother Malachi, and this is our commentary, Shalom.
Read it. Verse 12. Amos chapter 8, verse 12. And they shall wander from sea to sea.
And they shall wander from sea to sea. That means you're going from this place to this place. Well, let me go over here. Well, let me go over to the Christian church.
I don't know.
Well, maybe let me go into Hinduism.
Well, I don't know. I don't like this church because this preacher says that. I don't like this church because this preacher says that.
Let me tell you, if you were in the Word, it wouldn't matter what the preacher was saying. If you was in the Word, you'll be able to see over what he's teaching. But you're going from sea to sea, all over the place. Read.
Amos chapter 8, verse 12. And they shall wander from sea to sea, and from the north even to the east.
Okay.
They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Most High, and shall not find it.
You're going to wish one day you were able to sit in your cushy house and come on your computer and see the word of the Most High. You're going to long for that time. You're going to wish you had that opportunity. Soon, reading the Bible is going to be against the law of the earth. Soon. They're moving everyone into a new age movement. And the only thing you can believe in is yourself. Is yourself. And you are being programmed. That's going to be the belief system. Yourself. That's the new age movement. How grim and dark the government of this earth is. That all of them are in league and are in bed with the Satan. That's the truth. Not one of them are with the Most High. Why? Because this kingdom was given into the hand of Satan. Job 9 and 24 says the earth was given into the hand of the wicked. So in order for you to rule in this government, you must go to Satan to get your power. He tried to offer it to Christ. Christ denied it. But who took it? All the governments in this earth who will soon pay. They live lavishly in this earth off of bones, blood, sweat, and tears of the children of Israel. Yes, but now they have to pay. It's time. All these wars in the earth are culminating. They're leading to their own demise. And where does this appear with no weapon? This is our weapon. The only thing we have is this, is Christ in the name of the Most High. And we'll win.
It's the music and words of the Gathering of Christ Church, and you can find them at www.gatheringofchrist.org. Also, you can find them right now. There are two nights a week right here on Blog Talk Radio. For more information, you can go ahead and do the search on them right here at Blog Talk Radio. Or you can just go ahead and hit www.blogtalkradio.com/GOCCHURCH. All right. Also, if you want to get more information of the Hebrew Academy, which I am a graduate of, you can send an email to gatheringasone. That's the number one, gatheringasone@AOL.com. Tell them you'd like more information on the Hebrew Academy. And they will respond to your email and send you all the good. information on that. Okay, we're getting ready to get started in the book of Jasher, chapter 36. The book of Jasher, chapter 36. Just want to remind you also that you can get resources of the book of Jasher can be found at the Gathering of Christ Church.org's website and look at the link under resources. Also, they have the Book of Enoch there as well as the 1611 edition of the King James Version. We have a similar look at the book of Jasher, chapter 36. You can find it in Genesis chapter 35. Genesis chapter 35, it will give you similar to what the book of Jasher has at chapter 36. But those of you all who are joining us for the very first time, the book of Jasher mentioned in Joshua chapter 10, verse 13. Joshua chapter 10, verse 13. In chapter 1 of Joshua, the Most High said to Joshua, Joshua, meditate on the word day and night, for you shall have good success. So one of the books that Joshua had to meditate on was the book of Jasher. Okay, Jasher chapter 36, verse 1. At that time, the Most High appeared unto Jacob, saying, arise, go to Bethel and remain there, and make there an altar to the Most High, who appeareth unto thee, who delivered thee and thy sons from affliction. Verse 2. And Jacob rose up and his sons, and all belonging to him, and they went and came to Bethel according to the word of the Most High. Verse 3, and Jacob was 99 years old when he went up to Bethel, and Jacob and his sons and all the people that were with him remained in Bethel in Luz, S-L-U-Z, and he there built an altar to the Most High, who appeared unto him. And Jacob and his sons remained in Bethel 6 months. Verse 4. At that time died Deborah, the daughter of Uz, the nurse of Rebekah, who had been with Jacob, and Jacob buried her beneath Bethel under the oak that was there. Verse 5. And Rebekah, the daughter of Bethuel, the mother of Jacob, also died at that time in Hebron. The same is Kiriath Arba, and she was buried in the cave of Machpelah, which Abraham had bought from the children of Heth. Remember, we read in chapter 24 of last week, which was a special edition of this broadcast. In chapter 24, remember, Father Abraham bought land for his descendants. Verse 6, and the life of Rebekah was 133 years, and she died. And when Jacob heard that his mother Rebekah was dead, he wept bitterly for his mother, and made a great mourning for her, and for Deborah, her nurse, beneath the oak. And he called the name of that place Allah Baka. Verse 7, and Labai the Syrian died in those days, for the Most High smote him because he transgressed the covenant that existed between him and Jacob. Look out now. Verse 7, let's read it again. And Laban the Syrian died in those days, for the Most High smote him because he transgressed the covenant that existed between him and Jacob. Remember the time that Laban betrayed and told where what happened that Jacob had did that took his daughters from him? Okay. That is that reason. Verse 8, and Jacob was 100 years old when the Most High appeared unto him and blessed him and called his name Israel. And Rachel, his wife of Jacob, conceived in those days. Verse 9. And at that time, Jacob, also known as Israel, and all belonging to him, journeyed from Bethel to go to his father's house to Hebron. Verse 10. And while, let's check this out here, Hebron. Verse 9 again. And at that time, Jacob and all belonging to him journeyed from Bethel to go to his father's house to Hebron. They named that land Hebron. The original inhabitants named that land Hebron. Now, what does that symbolize or derive from? You remember it was Eber. Now you got the house to Hebron. So they were Hebrews. You get it? Hebrews. This is how our name changed, and we were called Hebrews because of the person and because of the land. The original. Remember the original. Remember when I said in chapter 24 in 2nd Esther, chapter 13, I believe, verse 40, when we, the Americas, was called at that time by the inhabitants and the 10 tribes, Esther, if I'm pronouncing it right, which means hidden land. And then Esau's descendants came over, starting with Columbus, and they began to change the names to North America, South America, and just start changing things up. Remember, well, this is the original right here, the land, which was Hebron. All right. Verse 10, and whilst they were going on the road, and there was yet but a little way to come to Ephrath, Rachel bare a son, and she had hard labor, and she died. Verse 11, and Jacob buried her in the way to Ephrath, which is Bethlehem. And he set a pillar up on her grave, which is there until this day. And the days of Rachel were 45 years, and she died. Verse 12, and Jacob called the name of his son that was born to him, which Rachel bare unto him, Benjamin. For he was born to him in the land on the right hand. Now, you all know that the descendants of Benjamin in the hemisphere today, in the Western hemisphere, is the Jamaicans. Going on to verse 13. Verse 13, and as well as Joseph, remember Joseph and Benjamin, that's why they were so close, because they had the same mom. They had the same father. They also had the same mom, but the other tribes had different moms. Verse 13, and it was after the death of Rachel that Jacob pitched his tent in the tent of her handmaid, Bilhah. Verse 14, and Reuben was jealous for his mother Leah on account of this. Let me back up and read this again. I got to read this because something is getting ready to happen with Reuben. And Reuben was jealous for his mother Leah on account of this. And he was filled with anger. And he rose up in his anger and went and entered the tent of Bilhah. And he thus removed his father's bed. Okay, verse 15. At that time, the portion of birthright, together with the kingling and priestly offices, was removed from the sons of Reuben. For he had profaned his father's bed, and the birthright was given unto Joseph. the kingly office to Judah and the priesthood unto Levi, because Reuben had defiled his father's bed. And you know, in Genesis chapter 49, and we're also going to see this again in one of the books in Jasher moving forward, you will see the prophecy of Reuben in a later chapter. And these are the generations of Jacob who were born to him in Padan Aram, and the sons of Jacob were 12. Verse 17, the sons of Leah. Now, here are the mothers, you all, of the 12 tribes. We're going to go ahead and break them down. And the sons of Leah were Reuben, the firstborn, and Simeon, Levi, Judah, Issachar, Zebulun, and their sister Dana. The sons of Rachel were Joseph and Benjamin. Verse 18, the sons of Zilpha, Leah's handmaiden, were Gad and Asher. And the sons of Belial, Rachel's handmaiden, were Dan and Naphtali. These are the sons which were born to him in Padan. Verse 19, and Jacob and his sons and all belonging to him journeyed and came to Mamre, which is Kerabba, that is in Hebron, where Abraham and Isaac sojourn. And Jacob with his sons and all belonging to him dwelt with his father in Hebron. Verse 20, and his brother Esau and his sons and all belonging to him went to the land of Seir and dwelt there and had possessions in the land of Seir. And the children of Esau were fruitful and multiplied exceedingly in the land of Seir. Verse 21, and these are the generations of Esau that were born to him in the land of Canaan. And the sons of Esau were five. Five sons did Esau have. Verse 22, and Adab bare to Esau his firstborn Eliphaz, and she also bare to him Raul, and Alabama bare to him Jeus, Yahlam, and Korah. Verse 23, these are the children of Esau who were born to him in the land of Canaan. And the sons of Eliphaz, the sons of Esau, were Teman, Omar, Zepho, Gatam, Kenaz, Amalek, and the sons of Reuel were Nakham, Zerah, Shema, and Mizah. Verse 24, and the sons of Jews were Timnah, Alva, Jetah, and the sons of Yalam were Allah, Philnor, and Kenaz. Verse 25, and the sons of Korah were Timon, Mibzah, Magdiah, and Iran. These are the families of the sons of Esau according to their dukedoms in the land of Seir. Now, look at this word right here, dukedoms in the land of Seir. Dukes. How does that sound in today's bloodline of someone you may know that is a duke? The dukes. I just want you to just kind of meditate on that as we move on. Verse 26, and these are the names of the sons of Seir, the Horite, inhabitants of the land of Seir: Lotan, Shoban, Zebon, Anah, Dishan, Ezer, and Dishan, being seven sons. Verse 27, and the children of Lotan were Horah, Hermon, and the sister Timnah, that is Timnah, who came to Jacob and his sons, and they would not give ear to her. And she went and became a concubine to Eliphaz, the son of Esau, and she bare to him Amalek. And she bare to him Amalek. And she bare to him Amalek. There's a reason for that. All right, verse 28. And the sons of Shobah were Avon, Manahath, Eben, Shepho, and Onan. And the sons of Zebon were Ajah and Anah. This was that Anah who found the Yemen in the wilderness when he fed the asses of Zebron, his father. Verse 29, and whilst he was feeding his father's asses, he led them to the wilderness at different times to feed him. Verse 30, and there was a day that he brought them to one of the deserts on the seashore, opposite the wilderness of the people. And whilst he was feeding them, behold, a very heavy storm came from the other side of the sea and rested upon the asses that were feeding there, and they all stood still. Verse 31, and afterward about 120 great and terrible animals came out from the wilderness at the other side of the sea, and they all came to the place where the asses were, and they placed themselves there. Verse 32, and those animals from the middle downward were in the shape of the children of men, and from the middle upward some had the likeness of bears, and some the likeness of the kippahs, with tails behind them from between their shoulders, reaching down to the earth, like the tails of the dung fat. And these animals came and mounted and rode upon their asses and led them away. And they went away unto this day. Verse 33, and one of these animals approached Anah and smote him with his tail, and then fled from that place. And when he saw this work, he was exceedingly afraid and his life, and he fled and escaped to the city. Verse 35, and he related to his sons and brothers all that had happened to him, and many men went to seek the asses, but could not find them, and Anah and his brothers went no more to that place from the day following, for they were greatly afraid for their lives. Verse 36, and the children of Anah, the son of Seir, were Dishon, and his sister Alabama, and the children of Dishon were Hermat, Ishbah, Itar, and Chiran. And the children of Ezer were Behal, Zavan, and Akal. And the children of Dishon were Uz and Aram. Verse 37, these are the families of the children of Seir, the Horite, according to the dukedoms. Remember that word, dukedoms or dukes, in the land of Seir. Last verse, and Esau and his children dwelt in the land of Seir, the Horite, the inhabitants of the land. and they had possessions in it and were fruitful and multiplied, exceedingly. And Jacob and his children and all belonging to him dwelt in their father Isaac in the land of Canaan, as the Most High had commanded Abraham their father. Now, this is the end of the book of Jasher, chapter 36. We will continue to chapter 37 next Sunday at this time, the book of Jasher, chapter 37. So my name is Brother Malachi. Until next time, we greet you farewell, and please get into the Word and read your Bible, your history book. Shalom, Israel.
Call my home, sunny war no more, live in Shalom. 144,000 of Jacob will make it in. Is Christ your friend? No need to pretend. Here's the question: did you walk in faith or did you walk in sin? Did you keep the law or did you pick and choose? Did you tell the truth about who's the real truth? There's no excuse, you had the truth, but you closed the book and turned on the news. And when Christ breaks the sky, every satellite will fall from space. Hit the earth to die, and then fight after disaster from the master. Puzzled faces looking for the rapture. True, the day that Christ provides birth, so they can watch it everywhere on earth.
Like heaven. When I'm gunned down, when the word is your weapon, and the Lord is your weapon. Not Baal, but our master's in heaven. And there's no more jails for the nation, that's heaven.
That's heaven.